Hi there, everybody. So there's a couple things I want to talk about. This one is going to be a movie review because I've been watching a lot of movies because I'm a film major. But before I want to get into the films, I just want to say that today is a terrible day. You want to know why? Because I woke up this morning to a freaking blanket of snow outside. A blanket, and everyone's like, "Ooh, it's just snow, not a big deal." No. I don't know how to explain how much I hate the cold and how much I hate the snow, other than when I was listening to the radio yesterday before this freaking snowstorm came, the snowstorm of death came. I was listening to the radio, Uncle Nasty's talking, 106.7, and he was like, "I really hate the snow. I think I want to go somewhere warm." And I'm like, "You know what? You're right. You're right." And the way he explained it, he says, every time he walks out to his car and sees an inch of snow on his windshield, he just wants to lay down in the snow until he gets hypothermia and dies. And I was like, yes, those are the words I've been looking for years. Every time I go out there, and my windshield is frozen, and my little wipers are like they just can't. I just want to die. I just want to say fuck it, lay down in the back of my car, keeping it running and like getting a garage or something. I don't know. I'm being melodramatic. I'm sorry. Snow's not that bad, but and the sun's starting to come out. Hopefully it'll melt it. But it was like 75 yesterday. 75 degrees. I wore a short sleeve shirt yesterday. And then this morning, I wake up and I'm like, "I am really freaking cold." Brr. And I'm wearing this big ass poncho. Warm as hell. Anyways, the movies I wanted to talk about, more relevant to anything. No one cares about my hatred of snow. But the movies I want to talk about, I thought I was super cool because I found this movie and I was like, wow, this is a really cool movie. It was really well done. And then I realized that it won a bunch of Oscars and it was like really popular and everyone on this pla in the planet Earth has like seen it besides myself. The movie's titled Pan's Labyrinth. I think that's how you say it. It's Labyr. I lost my train of thought. Labyrinth. Labyrinth. Anyways, Pan's Labyrinth, and it was super cool. I've been on this, like, sci-fi fantasy movie rut. Like, I've been in this rut of sci-fi fantasy, and I just want to stay there and live there. Like, I love fantasy movies, and I love sci-fi movies. So if you guys have any good fantasy sci-fi movies, besides Lord of the Rings, obviously, or, like, The Matrix, and, like, just movies that everyone's seen, don't send me those. But, tell me about some interesting movies, some fantasy sci-fi, or not, but just tell me about some interesting movies that I can watch. Also another one I watched, I think it was written for TV, I don't know, but George Clooney was in it and he gets naked. But oh shit, what was it called? Solaris. Solaris was really good. Really kind of weird because it kind of starts out like a horror flick. It kind of starts off kind of creepy and eerie and he goes up to the spaceship because they don't really know what's going on and there's just a lot of weird shit. It's kind of like there's a new movie that just came out where they like go on the spaceship and there's like this alien like attacking people. It kind of starts off like that, but this alien's like not attacking people, it's like imitating people and it's really crazy, but then it's kind of like you figure out that it's kind of not like an alien. And what I really liked about it is that you don't really get an answer. It's kind of like the ending of Inception, like you don't really get an answer of like what the hell just happened. You just kind of it leaves room for you to imagine, and it's awesome. You guys should definitely check that out. It's Solaris. It's spelled like solar and then is Solaris. It's pretty cool. It kind of gets into religion, and I don't know. Yeah, good. Also, I don't know why I'm gonna even review this movie because I don't even know the fucking title of it. It's a Swedish movie. Swedish movie. My roommate and I, Kyle, we were, I don't know, it was on Halloween. I had gotten home from the family party and he was like, I'm bored. And I'm like, let's watch a horror flick. So he gets on Netflix and finds the most random movie ever. And it was the Swedish film and it was like a vampire film, but you don't really know it's a vampire film until like within it. But it's not like it's what Twilight should have been. It doesn't really focus on the vampires much, which I didn't really like, but it focuses on their relationship, but it wasn't like a love relationship. Well, it was, it ended up being a love relationship, but they weren't like teenagers. The kid was like 13, and it was Swedish, so he's like, "Dude." That's not what he said. And Swedish doesn't actually sound like that, I'm just an idiot. But it was really cool. My other roommate who watched this with it, my third roommate who watched it with us, didn't really like it. But he, like, what does he know? He has ADHD. He didn't even watch the whole thing. He was up doing other shit during the movie. And I'm like, well, of course you didn't like it. You didn't even see it. But I liked it a lot. If someone knows what movie I'm talking about, seriously tell me. Because it was a Swedish film. Like, I don't remember the title of that movie. Like, I don't know. But, really, it starts out, it also starts out kind of like Solaris, really creepy, and then progressively gets less creepy, but more interesting. I really liked that. And the fourth movie, and I've probably talked about this before, but I just watched it again recently. It's a German flick. It's called Lola Rent. Translation, Run Lola Run, right? And, the director is Tom Tengen? Tengen? I don't know, really strange name. Well, not strange to them, but strange to me. I'm from Colorado. But really, really creepy. The whole like point of the movie is like if you were to turn left instead of right, and just like what could have been. And it literally the entire movie is one scene that replays over and over and over with alternate endings and alternate like she did this instead of that, so this happened. Like the butterfly effect, and it was so cool. You guys should seriously check that out. Really good flick. And, I mean, they have subtitles, so it'll be alright. Alright, that's all I have to say for today. Thank you guys for sending me videos to check out of different artists. If you want to send me something other than rap artists, that would be cool too, because I'm not a rap specialist. I'm not a music specialist, I just have an opinion. There's been a couple people sending me videos. Some were good, some were not so good. I watched one today. Shit. The E Money Tree and something. I don't know. The reason why I don't remember is because it wasn't that great. The rapping, the talent, like they have a lot of potential. I feel like their beat was really good, and I feel like there was a lot of really clever rhymes in there. But they had like a homemade video to go with it. And the quality was not very good, and that took away from, like, I couldn't pay attention to what they were saying. I couldn't pay attention to their beat. I literally, like, minimized the screen so I could listen to them without looking. And it helped a lot. They were actually pretty good. It's just, it was really corny. It looked really old school. It looked like an 80s sort of thing, but they weren't wearing 80s clothes. Like, it just, the way it was filmed was no bueno, and it just didn't look good. So, I don't have too many great things to say about it. That's all I have to say. I gotta go to class. See ya.